So today, in today's class, we'll be reading about, as yesterday we have studied about, you can see, we have studied about illumination, then we have studied about luminous flux, then what is lumen, luminous intensity, what is candela power, then what is brightness, glare, okay, till here. But still, while studying today's topic, that is the types of lighting, not lightning, it is the different types of lights which we see in our day-to-day life. Okay, that is different types of lighting we are talking about, not different types of lightning. This it is different types of lights which we'll talk about. While studying these different types of lights, like incandescent lights, then CFL lights, LED lights, these things you have seen. Everyone has seen these three different types of lights. While reading this also, we will come across the different parameters and the different important terms which we have learned from the last two classes. Okay? Because as they are very much important, maybe every day we'll be just repeating these things, like what is illumination, what is flux, what is candela, what is the unit of illumination. Yesterday we have talked the unit of illumination is lux, 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 and it is denoted by LX, small l, small x. Okay. So today is a very interesting topic. I hope everybody can see this particular frame. Can you see this here, all of you? No. There are three types of bulbs. Can you see the bulbs here? I hope these three different types of bulbs you can identify. Can you say what are these three types of bulbs which is there in your right-hand side extreme end? Total right-hand side extreme end, which type of bulb is there? It is somewhat looking like 100. This, okay, you see the mouse. Okay, this is which bulb? Any idea? Make it fast. So these are three different types of bulbs. Do you have any idea this right side? Which bulb it is? It is actually known as which bulb? It is known as incandescent bulb. What it is? Incandescent bulb. You have seen this 100 watt bulb, okay, 10 watt bulb, these bulbs you might have seen it. Okay. Now, mostly nobody is using nowadays, but still the cost of this incandescent bulb is very low as compared to other CFL and LED bulbs. Now, the middle one is which bulb? Any idea? The middle bulb, are you all there? Yeah, Sunil and Prajanan. The middle one, you can mute on. Don't mute. Just say the middle one. Can you see the picture? Can you name the middlemost bulb? Which bulb it is? The rightmost is incandescent bulb. The middle one is it CFL or LED bulb? The middle one. It is a CFL bulb, okay. And the last one, you can see left-hand side, it is a LED bulb, okay. Now you see, we have different options. Now, whenever these are the three different types of bulbs, with the help of which you can light your room or you can light your home, okay. So whenever you are selecting which type of lighting you need in your particular home, okay, so the three different types of bulbs which should come to your mind is, one is fluorescent bulbs, incandescent bulbs, or LED bulbs. Okay, so it depends on your own criteria that which particular bulb you are going to select. Clear? And whenever you are selecting a bulb to lighten your room or to lighten your home, which bulbs are needed, the first thing that should come, or that comes to your mind, not comes, that should come to your mind, is you are always looking into which consumes less electrical energy. And We are talking about those three types of lighting, though, that is incandescent, fluorescent and LED. We are talking about CFL, we are talking about LED, we are talking about incandescent bulb. Now, when we talk about these three are operated with the help of electrical energy. Okay, and I am not talking about glowing or lightening the bulbs with the help of solar panels or renewable energy. I am talking about electrical energy, commercial energy. Okay, now with the help of electrical energy, these are the three bulbs. Now, you always think about where I have to use that bulb where electrical energy consumption will be very minimum. Yes or no? So you are selecting a bulb where that bulb will consume less amount of electrical energy. Now, as you know from the last two classes, you have learned about different terms and different principles. I hope you can see here clear. Now, you have learned all these things. So what is illumination? Make it fast. For the next 2-3 minutes, we will learn again. What is illumination? Yesterday we have studied. Illumination means it is nothing but how much the light is distributed on a horizontal surface. Now, illumination means the distribution of light on a horizontal surface. Suppose you switch on the light in your room. So, how much light is distributed along that particular horizontal surface? That particular concept is known as illumination. Okay. Now, what is lumen? Lumen means, let me give an example, it is nothing but you are measuring how much light is emitted by a lamp. Lumen means it is a measurement of light. It is the unit of light. That means how much light is emitted by a particular lamp or by a bulb. Now, everybody has seen an 100 watt bulb. Have you seen 100 watt incandescent bulb? It is costing around 10 or 20 rupees. Earlier it was 10 rupees. Maybe I bought it long before, 5 to 6 years back. Have you seen this 100 watt bulb, 10 rupees bulb? Philips or Orient? Okay. Make it fast. Have you seen it or not? Clear? Now, that 100 watt bulb, if you go and ask, how much actually light it is emitting? It is actually emitting how much light? Please remember, how much light it is emitting? 1600 lumens. How much? Can you see this? Whatever I'm showing. It is emitting how much lumens? This much of light it is emitting. It's throwing. That is 1600 lumens. Okay. So remember this. A 100 watt bulb that bulb is called incandescent bulb. Incandescent bulb. Okay. Now, what is foot candle? Foot candle means we have learned like candela. Okay. This is a new term. It is also known as candela, or it is also known as foot candle. Now, what is foot candle? It is a unit of measurement of the intensity of illumination. Intensity of illumination, that measurement is called as foot candle. Sir, then what is foot candle? As in the name itself, it is there. Foot candle means how much one lumen distributed around one square foot area. How much? If one lumen of light is distributed around one square foot area, I hope you understand. One square foot area means there is a square whose sides are how much? 1 feet each. All the sides of a square are 1 feet. That particular area, one square foot area, in that particular area, whenever the light is actually illuminated, and how much light is illuminated? One lumen light is distributed over there. Okay. Now, remember, always, this might be very interesting and helpful for you in future also. Whenever in your house or whenever you are doing your office work, how much illumination is needed? If you are in home and if you are doing your office work, remember how much foot candles of illumination is needed? 30 to 50 foot candles. 30 to 50 foot candles. Now, if you want that your eyes, you see, there are some lights. Suppose you are reading in your home during your study time, during night time, and suppose if you are lighting from the bulb in your reading room is not sufficient, then your eyes are getting strained or not? Yes or no? Your eyes are paining. Yes or no? So why that happens is because there is insufficient amount of light. Clear? And due to that insufficient amount of light, your eyes get strained and you feel some pain in your eyes. So remember, if you want to avoid this kind, so remember, you need 200 foot candles of illumination. How much? 200 foot candles of illumination. But at night, where you are not doing any kind of work, this much of foot candle is sufficient. How much? 5 to 20 foot candles are sufficient. So these are the different things which we have studied already. What is the glare? Okay. Then what are the different types of lighting uses? Okay. Now, ambient lighting means, you see, you use lighting outside for safety and security, and inside you use lightning, that is illumination, you use only to do your day-to-day activities. Then there are certain lightings also for a specific task, that lighting is very much necessary when you go to this national highway or when you go to this foot over bridge. I'm talking about bridge, national highway, where you find a particular what we say, that foot over bridge. There you'll find in the middle or maybe in both the sides, lightings are there. I'm talking about halogen lights. That means for a particular task, you need a certain amount of lighting. Okay. Now, in your house, inside, is there any necessary of halogen light? Halogen light, is it necessary in your bedroom? Not necessary, but so that is what. So, depending upon the task, suppose in your house, there might be a puja room, or there might be a room where you are doing some certain rituals like pujas and all those things. There, are you putting any high watt bulb? Are you putting? No. Normally, you keep 5 watt bulb is sufficient, because only for a lesser amount of time you are using that particular room. And similarly, depending upon your own availability, depending upon your own consumption, how much light that is needed. Okay. So, you should be able to know, because again, getting an interior designer, sir, interior designer work is, it is her or his work, interior designer, to check, because you should have certain idea, because it is not possible to call an interior designer and pay him and say these minimum things, that how much light is needed. So, depending upon how much light you need it, it depends on which kind of bulb you have to use it. Okay. Now, there are some certain bulbs also which you put it. Like during Diwali, you might have seen these kind of lights. LED lights you have seen, which are flickering lights. Have you seen that? And some disco lights are also there. You just focus it on the road. Are you all getting? So, these lights, why you are putting it? Only to give some aesthetic look to your indoor and outdoor, and to gather some attention. Whoever is going from the road, to gather attention only, you are putting such kind of lights, LED lights. So, what I am trying to say over here is, so depending upon your ambient nature, or depending upon your aesthetic look, how you want your home to look alike, okay. So, all these things will, table lamps, then bathroom, which kind of lights you want to put. Somebody has the habit that just above that particular bathroom mirror, in the bathroom there is a mirror, above that mirror they put a very 2 to 3 watt bulb, they put it, okay. Then kitchen lights. So, in different rooms, the different kinds of lights should be placed, keeping in mind the energy consumption and keeping in mind the illumination part also. I hope you understood. Next is, we should also explore the which most of you, I know, you might not have that idea. So, what is designing options is lighting designs. Can you see here, all of you? Okay, yeah. Here you can see one. There is a house here. Internally, you see different kinds of indoor lighting is there. Indoor, outdoor lighting. Okay. Now, why this indoor lighting, outdoor lighting is given is in order to improve the both quality and efficiency of lighting. Okay. You will see some of the houses where it is a very big house, but when you enter into the house during nighttime or during evening time when the sun sets, what happens is the kind of lighting that particular house inside interior it needs, you find that it is very dim. Clear? So by that, you can understand what is the quality of lighting that this particular inside the house they are having, and what is the efficiency of lighting. So it depends upon these things. So again, one more thing is energy efficiency you should take care of. It is not that, sir, it's a big house, I put in every room, I put halogen lights. No, again, it is wastage of electricity and it is a wastage of light also. Okay, so this particular indoor outdoor light design, then you should have light is in indoor, which type of light is needed for outdoor. Now remember, there are some tricks or there are some things you should remember. Now in interior, whenever you're designing indoor lighting, whenever you're taking care of, you should think about quality. Okay, more than quantity, you should think about quality. What I'm trying to say is, in a particular room, don't put more bulbs, like 4 to 5 bulbs in a single room. Okay, besides the quantity, it's better you put a good quality bulb, a single good quality bulb which will illuminate the total room. Okay, now not only that, depending upon the function, suppose it is a reading room, if it is a bedroom, if it is a kitchen, so you should try to calculate and find out how much amount and what is the quality of light that is required to perform a particular function. You see, to study how much light is required, you know. Okay, you know it, but you maybe presently, if I ask you, you cannot say exactly how much lumens is required, how much illumination is required. The unit of illumination is lumens, LUMENS. You cannot say, sir, I need 1500 lumens to study. Sir, I need 1000 lumens to offer prayers, or I need, sir, 1200 lumens for in the bedroom, or sir, I need 1800 lumens in a kitchen room. So that particular exact value you cannot say, but at least you should have that idea. Okay, at least by visualization you can easily say yes or no. By visualization you can say, sir, this particular light is a little bit dim as compared to when I put it in this particular room. Okay, so depending upon that, you should also have always remember, have more and more skylights. You understand skylights? Skylights means you take the you utilize this particular daylight. Daylight means how can you get daylight if you have proper ventilation throughout your house. Around the house, if you have proper ventilation, proper windows, proper skylights, if you have, then minimum energy consumption will be there. So that is what he's saying. So you will find some houses where there is very good ventilation. Okay, and there are some tricks also. In some houses you'll see that glass windows or glass panel windows are there, because through which light can easily pass through it. So from morning 6 to evening 6, the 12 hours you can save energy at least through light. Suppose in and around nowadays, I'm not talking about village areas or the rural areas, I'm talking about urban areas where you see from building to building or apartment to apartment, you don't find any what you can say very much distance. So you'll see that if besides your bedroom or besides your any kitchen room, if there is a particular house, So there is no proper ventilation. You are going to do a particular work in that kitchen or maybe in bedroom or study room. Throughout the day, you need a light, you need a bulb, which is unnecessary wastage of light. So while you are designing also, you should take care. While designing also, you please take care whether this particular designing your house, okay, proper ventilation is there or not. Most of the daylight you try to use it. Now the basic methods which you should always follow whenever you are thinking about saving energy. The best one is, you know, ceiling. In the ceiling, you know, ceiling means the roof. Okay, please answer somebody. Okay, ceiling. All of you know what is ceiling. So in ceiling, it is better always try to fix this LED lights. Are you all there? Yeah. In the ceiling, you always try to put this particular LED lights or one more type of light. I told you is CFL lights. Okay, fluorescent lights. Clear. Nowadays, very small size fluorescent lights has also arrived in the market. Come to the market now. Every day, not more than 2 hours each day in kitchen, living room, bathroom. Okay, you should design your house, or you should interior design. You should do in that way that you should always keep in your mind that throughout the day, your target is to light the bulb or switch on the bulb only for 2 hours. Only for 2 hours means not all the lights in your house for 2 hours. Okay, now if you are in the bedroom, there is unnecessary no need to switch on lights of your kitchen and bathroom. If you are watching TV, okay, only the living hall light is necessary. So depending upon your usage, you try to minimize your energy consumption. Okay, by which you can improve your efficiency, energy efficiency. Now not only that, you can also some people, what they do is, I'm talking about this, if you need a high glow, sometimes what they do is, if you talk about my particular house, in almost all, you'll see LED lights, and LED lights will be there in this particular bedroom, and in your living hall, you will find this CFL bulbs. In kitchen, CFL bulbs will be there. And in CFL bulbs, small CFL bulbs of 5 watt will be there in the bathrooms. But one incandescent lamp will be there. Wherever I go, one incandescent lamp of this 100 watt bulb. One I will use it. But that particular 100 watt bulb, again, there may be a doubt in your mind. Sir, where you are using it? I try to use it in the balcony, this incandescent bulb, in the balcony or in front of that particular door. And I use it maximum, I use it only throughout the day. During night time only, I use that particular bulb. Maximum 30 minutes, not more than that. Yeah, because it consumes power. So, at least in the screen, We have stopped here. We were talking about these occupancy sensors. Remember, nowadays in the market, we can control these lights. Everybody, can you see this white color board? Make it fast. This white color board, can you see? So this is your actually. It is a control, or you can say it is a sensor. Okay. So it is a sensor, white color. I hope everybody can see. Now here, using this particular lighting controls, you can turn off the light or turn on the light whenever you are needed, and you can save the energy. Now you can save energy. When can you save the energy? If you can turn off the lights whenever they are not needed. But sometimes